The Fluence breakout functionality allows an interesting piece of data to be further explored and broken down into component parts. In this video, we will create a simple breakout to show the top products sold for a specified country. This grid contains the sale amount at country level for the years 2022 to 2023, broken down by quarter. To add our breakout, we can right-click on a piece of data in the grid, go to the Fluence Excel menu, and then select Breakout Value. Or we can directly use the Grid Ribbon option to breakout. Both will open the breakout menu. In the breakout menu, we'll choose to place the breakout to the right of our grid. This way, if we drill into the grid and it expands further down, it won't overwrite our breakout. Next, we will choose the hierarchy to populate the breakout. In this case, we'll pick the product categories hierarchy. We want to see the top 10. And finally, we'll choose the descendants at product level. There is a selection to track the active cell. This will make more sense once the grid is inserted. So let's go ahead and click OK. We now have our breakout showing the top 10 products for the active cell in our grid. As I click on different cells in the grid, the breakout will update as the track active cell option was enabled. So I am seeing the data for one country and then a different based on the active cell. The breakout is just a basic Fluence Excel grid and functions in the same way. So if we wanted to edit it, we can simply open up the grid designer in the same way we would any other grid. We can do this by right-clicking on any of the data, go into the Fluence Excel menu, and click in Design. We can also use the grid properties to change the title displayed. So here I can name it the top 10 products. Breakouts add another dynamic dimension to your reporting, where you can quickly see how the selected number is split across any other hierarchy. You can further enhance this by having multiple breakouts linked to the same grid.